In this video, we're going to discuss about proposition number 3. So, meron na tayong 1 and 2 sa ating previous lesson. So, bago tayo mag-proceed sa proposition number 3, let's have corollary. So, ito yung corollary from the previous proposition. So, let's have corollary 1. Corollary 1. So, according to corollary 1, or our first corollary sa ating discussion, if A is a subset of B, subset of Rn, and the outer measure of B is finite, then the outer measure of B minus the outer measure of A is less than, always less than or equal to the outer measure of B minus A. Okay, so take note of that. When we say B minus A, that means elements ni B na wala kay set A. Okay, so hindi natin siya ipoprove. So pwede nyong practicein, pwede nyo siyang i-prove. But our focus for this topic is proposition number 3. Okay, so let's have proposition 3. Okay, so for our proposition 3, we have, let's say we have any close interval. So for any close interval, I, subset of Rn, take note that M star of I or outer measure of I is always equal to the volume of I. So napakahalaga ng proposition na yan. Kasi madali na lang natin mahahanap kung ano yung outer measure ng isang close interval. So para makuha natin yung outer measure ng close interval, kunin mo lang yung volume niya. So yung pagkuha ng volume niya ng close interval, so na-discuss natin yun sa second video natin, yung volume ng close interval. Okay, so nandun na yung formula. So ang gagawin natin, let's prove this statement. Okay, so to prove this statement, ang gagawin natin, yung idea ng trichotomy. So kung equal, papakita natin una na yung outer measure of I is less than or equal sa volume. So yan yung una nating papakita. Pangalawa, papakita naman natin yung volume ng I ay less than or equal sa outer measure of I. Okay? So, pag napakita na natin yan, pwede nating makonclude na yung outer measure of I ay equal sa volume of I. So, yan yung gagawin nating approach sa proof. Okay? So, let's have our proof. Okay, so for our proof, unahin natin to. Yung statement na to, outer measure of I less than or equal to volume of I. Okay, so ang gagawin natin, mag-set tayo ng covering para kay I. So set S, and of course, the best covering for the interval I or for the close interval I is the close interval I itself. Okay, so the close interval I itself can cover the interval I or close interval I. So, kaya niyang i-cover yung sarili niya. So, yan yung the best covering na pwede nating ma-provide. So, set S equals set containing I as a covering. Okay, by the way, yung una yung papakita natin of I by close intervals. Okay. So, if yung I ay yung kung yung S natin containing I, yung covering natin, by definition ng covering, that means, or this follows, outer measure of I less than or equal to sigma of S. Okay? So, pinakita ko na yan from the definition of outer measure. So, that will be less than or equal to sigma of S. Again, when we say sigma of S, that is the sum of the volume ng lahat ng nasa loob ni S. Okay? But since ang nasa loob ni S dito ay si I lang, so, meaning, ang kukunin lang nating sigma ay yung si I lang. Okay? But since mag-isa nga lang siya, so, hindi na kailangan nating i-add sa kung ano yon, kung sa other intervals, kasi mag-isa lang siya. So, yung mismong volume na lang ni I, yung sigma of I dyan. Okay? So, this implies outer measure of I is less than or equal to volume of I. Okay, so wait, nagulo. This is I. Okay? And ito yung gusto nating ipakita, yung una. Outer measure of I is less than or equal to volume of I. Okay, so done na tayo. Ito na lang yung second, yung pakita natin. Medyo tricky yung pangalawang part. So, volume of I less than or equal to the outer measure of I. Okay, so doon tayo sa second part ng ating proof. So, for our second part, magsaset tayo ng panibagong covering para kay I. Okay? And this time, ang gagawin natin, set S is equals I sub K. Let's say, as accountably. So, let's choose S to be accountably infinite covering. Okay. Of I by close intervals. Okay. So, this time, kailangan nating mapakita na yung volume of I ay less than or equal sa outer measure of I. And in order to do that, pakita natin yung volume of I ay less than or equal kay sigma of S. So, ito yung goal natin. Kasi pag nagawa natin to, susunod na to. Okay? So, ito yung itarget natin. Now, so ang gawin natin, mag-provide tayo ng expanded version para kay I sub K. Okay? So, i-expand natin tong I sub K. So, let epsilon be positive, any arbitrary positive real number, and let I sub K star, let's call it I sub K star. So, ano si I sub K star? So, siya yung expanded version of I sub K. Taas muna natin to. I sub K. Such that, i-specify natin. So, paano natin i-expand si I sub K? So, una, i-expand natin siya in a way na yung I sub K natin ay subset ng interior of I sub K star. Okay? So, sa ganyang paraan natin siya i-expand. Kumbaga, kapag kinuha natin yung interior lang ni I sub K star, then, laman na nun yung I sub K. Okay, nasa loob na nun si I sub K. And, lagyan natin ng limit, lagyan natin ng restriction yung volume ng ating I sub K star para hindi siya masyadong hindi siya masyadong expand. So, hindi exaggerated yung pagkaka-expand ni I sub K star. So, para magawa yon, dun tayo kay volume. So, let's say yung volume ni I sub K star. So, ito yung purpose ni epsilon, positive epsilon. This will be less than or equal to 1 plus epsilon. Mamaya makikita nyo kung bakit naglagay ako ng 1. So, may purpose yan. So, 1 plus epsilon multiplied by the volume of I sub K. Ano ibig sabihin yan? Ang ibig sabihin yan, we have volume of I sub K less than or equal to volume of I sub K star. So, obvious yon. Bakit? Si I sub K ay, si I sub K star ay expanded version ni I sub K. So, malamang, mas malaki yung volume niya. But if we multiply 1 plus epsilon, okay? So, let's say epsilon is an arbitrary real number. So, kahit liitan natin yung value ni epsilon. So, if we multiply the volume of I sub K by 1 plus epsilon, ang mangyayari, hindi na aabot dun. Okay? Or hindi na lalagpas pala dun. Hindi na lalagpas sa value na yon yung volume ni I sub K star. Okay? So, meaning, hindi siya masyadong malaki. Hindi siya mas malaki dito kay 1, kay volume of I sub K star na nakamultiply sa 1 plus epsilon. Okay? So, nilimitahan natin yung pagkaka-expand ni I sub K star. Okay? So, parang ganito, ito si I sub K. Let's say, ito si I sub K. And then, this is our, this is our I sub K star. Okay. So, let's say this is our I sub K star. Okay. So, in-expand natin, pero hindi sobra yung pagkaka-expand niya. Hindi siya lalagpas sa multiple of 1 plus epsilon. Okay, or sa factor na 1 plus epsilon times volume of I sub K. Okay? So, hanggang dyan lang siya. Now, tuloy natin. Ngayon, kung yung I sub K natin, laman ni S, which is si S ay covering ni I, that means kapag pag pinagsama-sama natin lahat ng interior of I sub K star sa isang set, yung set na yon magiging covering din ni I. Syempre, kung yung mas maliit, kinocover niya yung interval. So kapag pinalaki natin yon, makocover niya rin yung close interval. Okay? So then, next natin. Then, the set containing interior of I sub K star is an open cover. Open cover because we're talking about interior. Okay? Interior ng close interval. So, meaning, hindi kasama yung boundary ng close interval. So, naka-open yun. Okay? Kaya open cover. So, that is from definition ng covering, si I ay subset ng union or generalized union of the interior of I sub k star k is from 1 to infinity. Okay? Bakit ganyan up to infinity? Because we let I sub k or we let s to be countably infinite, meaning there are infinite number of I sub k. So meaning, si I sub k star expanded version ng bawat I sub k. So meron din tayong infinite number of I sub k star. That is why we have the union from k equals 1 to infinity. Kasi infinite yung number ng I sub k natin. Infinite yung pinag-union natin. Now, since I is compact, since I is compact, okay, ano ibig sabihin ulit pag compact? Ibig sabihin yan, close and bounded yung I natin. So, meaning, from the idea na alam natin kay compact, si I can be covered by a finite subcover okay, say I subset of union of interior of I sub k star k equals 1 to, let's say, M. Because we're talking about the finite subcover la. Okay? So, yun yung characteristic kay compact, no? So, pwede siyang makover ng finite number of close intervals. Okay? So, we say subcover because itong interior or union of interior of I sub k star galing lang dito. Okay? So galing lang siya dito sa una natin. And take note that since eto mga interior lang ng I sub k star, so this is subset, this is a subset of the union of I sub k star. So eto yung kasama na yung boundary ni I sub k star. K equals 1 to M. Okay? So, M yan. Medyo magulo yung sulat. M. Okay. Okay? So, anong ibig sabihin yan? So, this means ang gawin na lang natin, ipagsama rin natin sa covering yung kanina pinagsama natin sa isang set si interior of I sub k star. So ipagsama natin din sa isang set si I sub k star. Okay? So kung yung I covering din, I mean kung yung I sub k star ay covering din ng I, isama natin siya sa isang set. Tapos, yun yung tawagin nating, let's say, S prime. Okay? So, this means that S prime, which is equal to set containing I sub k star. Okay? So, lagyan natin para makita natin na finite siya from 1 to M. So, meaning, we're talking about the finite number of close intervals sa loob ni S prime. Okay? So, nilagyan ko ng ganyan to indicate that finite si S prime. Okay? So, si S prime, covering din ni I. So, this means S prime is a covering of I. A covering of I of I by a finite number of close intervals. Okay? Now, kung si S prime containing I sub K star ay covering ni I, that means, or let's say, hence, yung volume ni I ay less than or equal sa summation of volume of I sub K star. Okay? From K equals 1 to M. Because this S prime containing I sub K star is a covering. Kinocover niya si I. So meaning, pag pinag-plus-plus mo yung volume, lahat ng volumes na nasa loob ni S prime, mas malaki siya. Or let's say, equal to volume of I. Okay? And mula dito sa restriction natin, volume of I sub K star is less than or equal to 1 plus epsilon volume of I sub K. So meaning, this summation is less than or equal to summation of 1 plus epsilon times volume of I sub K, K equals 1 to M. Okay? So, ang gulo ng epsilon ko. 1 plus epsilon. Now, pwede nating ilabas yung 1 plus epsilon. So, this is equal to 1 plus epsilon. Ilalabas lang natin si 1 plus epsilon. Summation of volume of I sub K, K equals 1 to M. Kung ibabalik natin siya sa infinity, okay? Ang mukhang H to, magulo. Mukhang H. So, let's make it 1 plus epsilon. Okay. So, kung ibabalik natin tong finite sa infinity, magiging mas lalaki yung volume, syempre, kasi madadagdagan yung volume niya. So, this will be less than or equal to 1 plus epsilon summation of volume of I sub K, K equals 1 to infinity. And this summation is sigma S. So, 1 plus epsilon sigma of S. Now, since epsilon is arbitrary, so, as epsilon approaches 0, this will be 1 times sigma of S. So, ang mangyayari na lang, si outer measure or si volume of I will be less than or equal to, dito na lang matitira kay sigma S. Sigma S. At yan yung unang-una nating target, yung sinabi ko sa inyo. Okay? So, ang sabi ko kanina, ito yung unahin natin. So, naka-arrive na tayo dito, susunod na to, yung number 2. Okay? So, paano, bakit siya susunod? Kasi, kung yung volume of I ay less than or equal sa sigma of S, where S is a covering of I by closed intervals, countably infinite covering ng I. So, that means, this implies volume of I less than or equal to the infimum of sigma of S. Okay? Such that S is a covering of I. Okay? So, bakit siya less than or equal sa infimum? Kasi nga, yung infimum, siya yung pinakamalaking upper, pinakamalaking lower bound. Kung si volume of I ay lower bound ni sigma of S, ang pinakamalaki doon, si infimum. So, that's why, infimum is either greater than kay volume of I, which is another lower bound ni sigma of S, or maybe equal to volume of I. So, kung equal, that means si volume of I mismo yung infimum ng sigma of S. Okay? And when we say infimum of the set containing sigma of S, by definition of outer measure, that means volume of I is less than or equal to outer measure of I. Okay? So, we can now conclude, since outer measure of I is less than or equal to volume of I, yung first part, and volume of I is less than or equal to outer measure of I, yung second part. So, by trichotomy property, we have outer measure of I equals volume of I.